תודה לפרופסור בן טולילה על ההרצאה, באמת טעמנו על קצה המזלג מהעבודה, עבודת הנמלים שפרופסור בן טולילה עשה, ערך וחקר, אבל מאחר שהזמן שלנו לא מתאים לארבע הרצאות, אני בכל אופן מנסה להכניס כאן ארבע הרצאות, אז אני מתנצלת. הרצאה האחרונה תחרוג קצת מן הזמן, אני מבקשת מן הקהל להישאר. המרצה האחרון שלנו הוא דוד בן חמו חימנס. הוא ירצה על an introduction to the linguistic of Melilla's Jewish community. בן חמו הוא סטודנט לדוקטורט the Open National University of Spain. הוא עוסק בחקיתיה ובהופעות של המלילה קומיוניטי, בהופעות של קהילת המלילה היהודית והאזכורים שלה. הוא פרסם מאמרים באנגלית ובספרדית. בבקשה.
יש לך מצגת?
אין בעיה. איפה עושים נקסט?
חץ למטה.
פה, נכון?
כן.
למטה או...
הנה, למטה. אני אראה לך רגע, בוא נפתח את זה. זה לך מסך מלא, פה.
אוקיי, תודה רבה. צהריים טובים, good afternoon. I am pleased to provide you with an introduction to the linguistic of the Jewish community of Melilla. Melilla is nowadays the only active community in the area of Eastern Morocco, even though that it fully belongs to the Kingdom of Spain, and is by far the largest remaining community in the north of Africa, I mean in the Spanish Morocco, and we say this whole Morocco with Casablanca, the only one remaining today. The city was founded in 1865 mostly by wealthy Jews from Tetuán looking for new business opportunities and additional Jews from rural areas of Chaguán, Devdú, Taza, Orán and other locations. The Jews that are there today are from those mentioned. The city is only 12 square kilometers, and as well as the Jewish community, they were and are even today completely isolated. Before, they used to have some, the Jewish community have to some businesses with the Morocco, but nowadays they are a bit scared of going to Morocco. You can see the fence, which is the border also between Europe and Morocco. The mainland Spain is also far. It's 9 hours by boat and 1 hour by plane, a plane that only departs a few times a day. The Jewish community was once in the city 8,000 members, a third part of the city. In the 80s, it reached the 3,000 Jews. When a few months ago I forward my proposal to this Congress, there were 1,000. And currently, we have 636 members. The number seems insignificant, and in fact, it is. But due to the location and size of the city, even smaller than Falsava, in the outskirts of Tel Aviv, a said number represents still a considerable density of Jews, 4% of Melilla's entire population, and it allows a frequent contact among the Jewish members. This isolation and contact have both brought many negative consequences to the city and the Jewish community. However, it has positively contributed to preserve, to our days, one of the most valuable treasures of the Jewish community. His Sephardiness, in religion, in habits, in tradition, and of course, it includes our Haketia or our broken Haketia, and in a very particular way, in the community of Melilla. Entering into linguistics, I would like to comment some aspects and inconvenience that I'm facing in my research, which has not yet been concluded. I have already interviewed 230 informants, most of them Jews from Melilla, but as well those living abroad, mainly in Spain, Panama, and Israel, where they are arriving lately. I have also interviewed non-Jews married or living with Jews with an origin in Melilla. I record them, I send them surveys, I follow their private WhatsApps and Facebook conversation among other sources. I have to say that this community is extremely reserved and completely against the transfer or jargon to any context different than their own privacy. Besides, I want to say that Jaquetia has not widely researched in the academic field. In the Jaquetia of Melilla, less. There are just some superficial references in some historical books of the city written in Spanish. It makes it difficult for me to compare my work with other researchers, and as a speaker, it's hard to communicate with people in this language, even though that they are speakers of Jaquetia, because they need to be from the same area. At last, I want to comment with this example, a problem that I'm finding. The Israeli Jewish Academia, I have the appreciation that they tend to look for the Hebrew element of the language, while the Spanish try to look for the medieval or Latin Roman point of view. In my research, I'm aiming to get the best vision and to get the best things of them. For example, in the first example, we have soté, or sotá in feminine, and it isn't pronounced in standard Jaquetia. By standard Jaquetia, I refer myself to the Jaquetia of Tangier, Tetuán, Larache, and basically the northwestern part of Morocco. Then we have in Spanish, zote, which is stupid, ignorant. This is a word that is still in the National Dictionary of the Language, DRAE, but it's not longer used by the speakers, the Spanish speaker, just those that want to make any reference to the literature or medieval literature. In Hebrew, we have the word shote, tipes, jose ravana, and now is where the Jaquetia of Melilla come. We don't say sote, like in standard Jaquetia, we say sote. And we go farther, because of the influence of the Spanish, we say sotia, okay? And then some of them even say sotio, which is a new masculine form that we have created. For me, of course, it's important the etymology of the words, but what is more important is to show you that there is a community that is still using quite a lot Jaquetia in the daily life. After providing the government of Melilla with some proof, they have included as an official language in the Declaration for a Pact of Interculturality of Melilla that the Jaquetia is an official language. This is a public document, and I just translate and read page 35. Jaquetia is an historical linguistic treasure related to the Jewish community of Melilla that has been combined itself with other local languages, would result in a Jaquetia with his own personality. Page 36. Jaquetia is a combination of several languages with a base in Ladino oral tradition and that is resisting itself to disappear. I will right now will provide you with some examples obtained from my interviews in Melilla of what I call the Jaquetia of Melilla or the Eastern Jaquetia. Of course, when I say the Jaquetia of Melilla or Eastern Jaquetia, this is a shortcut because I really mean the broken Jaquetia of the Jewish of Melilla mixed with Amazigh of the area and also influenced by the Spanish. I have divided the example in the three planes of the language. I appreciate that the morphosyntactic plane has more similarities to the standard Jaquetia, and that's why for us it's in this plane easier to understand the speaker of Jaquetia of the area of Tetuán, Tangier. On the other hand, in the lexical semantic plane, it's harder for us to understand the other speaker of Jaquetia because there is a further evolution. For example, in the first example, we have Adrea Celo a la Sajena, Adra from speak to talk, and then the last part is the suffix in Spanish. Sajena, I'm pronounced Sajena, it's not like in Hebrew Shkena, it is neighbor, we know that, but for us it's someone that doesn't belong to the group, that is not Jews or it has a pejorative meaning sometimes. And then I have add Sajena, Shajena, and Sajena. Why is that? Because even that the Jaquetia is an oral language, as I'm taking WhatsApp, which is a spontaneous way of seeing Jaquetia, this is the three ways I'm finding Jaquetia. The first one with J is how a Jew that is still in Melilla or in Spain will write it. The second one is like someone, a Ole Hadash, that has been here for 5-6 years, is writing with CH, with the influence of how the Israelis write English. And the last one, probably someone that has made a mistake or of a lower cultural position or doesn't know how to write. The second example is the same. Nos rajleamos para tefila de obdia. So you have ruh in Arabic, to go, and we add the second part. In the third example, cerquear, jarsear, or we even say jarsear, like full Spanish, we have a difference with the standard jaquetilla. Why? In Spain, we have, for example, the word calzado, to say shoes. In Andalusia, the south of Spain, they don't say calzado, they say calzao. They change the letter A-L to R, and we are close to Andalusia, so we are influenced by the Andalusian way of speaking Spanish. Cerquear, jarsear. But you see, still, the other speaker of Jaquetilla could understand all those examples. And then, un gial, una giala. We add the feminine to the word gial, handsome, and then the word endiamantado, we understand the word, but we don't use it. Because this is a rhetorical element of the jaquetilla. They used to play several words meaning the same thing, and it's very repetitive in Spain, in Spanish. So we say un gial, una giala. Then we come to the phonetic phonological plane. Still, we can understand the standard speakers of jaquetilla, but we can see more differences. For example, we change all the G and J to S in jaquetilla. Standard jaquetilla, they will say la giana de la sharfa se gineo, and we say la seana de la sarfa se sineo. But what we do? Seana is not very exotic for us. What we do, we make the zain sound to zeana. We believe like that is more Arabic or more Hebrew, it's more exotic. This is just came natural on the speaker. On the second part, we don't say sharfa, as it is in original jaquetilla. We say charfa or sarfa. That's why in our community people say Shabbat Shalom. They never say Shabbat Shalom. They are not able to pronounce that. And then we have three sentences that may be understood by non-Jewish Spanish from any city of Spain, but that they will not get the whole meaning of those sentences because it doesn't came natural on them. It's not natural of a speaker of Spanish. For example, we say así se quede la descansada with totally Spanish pronunciation. Even the original is así se quede la descansada. We just say the Spanish pronunciation, so someone will understand, but they won't get the whole meaning. And it happened the same thing with no vea yo mal en ti, no sea tu falta mi bueno. And the last example in these planes are the word stajear y estarras. Okay, stajear, the Spanish someone when he's learning English, they cannot say, I am learning Spanish. They say Spanish. It's very difficult for the Spanish people to say the liquid S. So that's why they add an E at the beginning of anything starting by S. Estándar, Spanish. Okay, so that's why we say estajear. And we say estarras, okay? And then zaras is not a jaquetilla. It's a thing from Berberic, and then we change into D. So as you see, we check always for our examples. And you see the first Berberian word that when I have spoken with people speaking standard jaquetilla, it's hard for them to know what the meaning of this word is. And then for me, this is the more interesting, field. The lexical semantic, for example, we have the word mera and shoch. This is the way we pronounce. We know both words, but still we always try to use the one that is for us more Arabic or more Berberian. Then we have a word that until now I'm sure someone knows where it came from. Until now I think it's from Berber. We say och sifos, ach sifos, sifos. This is the way we pronounce and they pronounce in their interview. it means like stam in Hebrew. At least it means in our jargon. And then I have two words, maclear y colear. Okay, the first one I have found it in the dictionary of Jaquetia, but the second one I haven't been able to find it. We say it all the time, colear. It came from Arabic, kullu, tell him, but we don't say kullu, we say colear. It sounds completely like Spanish, so any Arabic will understand what we are saying, especially because it has the suffix in Spanish, so it's harder for them. And the first one is from akal in Arabic. And then we have neologism. We have created in our community of Melilla neologism. They say that the most neologism a language is able to create, the more alive it is. We have pillus for saying police, creating the way we create words in Arabic in Hebrew with the roots. And then we have makoda, in Arabic makuda. Of course we know it's an omelette, and in our community it's an omelette. But also in Spanish, someone called tortillera is a lesbian person. So in Jaquetia we say, ella es makoda, she's lesbian. And then we even go shorter, we say, ella es maco, like we make shorter in Spanish, like Nicolás, Nico. It's a way of shortening the names. And then we have the word jarrear. I'm sorry, but it means to go to the toilet, okay? We use it, this word like this, but we also use when we are scared, but this came from the Spanish. Estoy cagado de miedo, I'm scared. So if I say, me jarreé de saltar, I'm scared to jump, okay? Then we have one word that has been the other way around. We have mi rey. This word is even used by Muslims in Melilla because they hear all the time the Jewish community. However, if I go in Madrid and I say to someone mi rey, it sounds a bit girly with some connotations. So we just say querido, or so it's a word that has jumped from the Jaquetia to the Melillan way of speaking. I have heard also this word, of course, in Tetuán, in Tangier, but the problem is that they are not used there. Okay, I want to say that, for concluding, that in comparison with Israel, where the Jaquetia seems to be used for humor and traditions, in Melilla, the use and their descendants abroad, also in Israel and Panama, where they are mainly, our Jaquetia continue to be present for functionality, then because of the contact among the members, and then as a humor element. There is also a joining element, no matter where they came originally, if they were rich or they had a higher cultural level, all of them of any age, if they are more or less religious, even though that the community is quite religious, they all are able to understand and express themselves in this kind of Jaquetia in informal context, when of course we are with us. And then the last thing I want to point out is the word emergency. In a recent meeting with the Jewish agency, they say that this community has an excellent and comfortable life in this beautiful European city. It's European, actually. That is completely Sephardic. However, it is a main source of jihadism, where the pushing Arabic population has reached the 67% out of the total of the city. I am researching linguistics of the community, but I would be pleased that someone also will research many other wonderful aspects of the city. I want to thank Professor Bentolila for his wonderful work and for setting a way for the Jaquetia in Israel, also for the wonderful explanation that he has given before. And very personally to Dr. Nina Pinto Abecassis, that recently published a book about the Jaquetia of the Jewish of Tetuán. Also for the personal support he's giving to my work. And I also want to thank Vensi for giving an opportunity to a young researcher like me. And of course, I want to say thank you to my mom and my brother that at least until now, they allow me to continue speaking with them in this broken jaquetia, or this jaquetia of Melilla. Thank you so much. Toda rabba.
תודה רבה על ארבע ההרצאות המצוינות. אני מצטערת, אבל המושב הזה חרג מן הזמן, אז אני מציעה פרופסור שטרית ואחרים שיפנו למרצים בעצמם. Okay.